Pancreatic Protocol CT Scan. Concepts of Surgery. Join our YouTube channel to learn surgery in a simple way. Pancreatic cancer is an aggressive malignancy, hence it is vital to diagnose it at an early stage. Therefore, a protocol was designed for performing CT scan in suspected case of pancreatic cancer, which essentially contains guidelines for performing CT scan to increase sensitivity in picking up small tumors. It is important to understand that conventional CT scan can diagnose larger masses. Pancreatic protocol is designed to detect smaller mass. For example, if a pancreatic mass is detected by transabdominal ultrasound, then it would probably be at least more than 2 cm in size. So in this case, conventional CT scan without pancreatic protocol, double phase or triple phase, would suffice. Suppose, in an obstructive jaundice case, on conventional CT scan there is dilatation of CBD till lower end, but no mass present or doubtful lesion present at lower end, then this case deserves pancreatic protocol CT scan to delineate small pancreatic tumor. So what is this pancreatic protocol? Let us understand this step by step. First, scan type. Scan type is helical, which is preferred method nowadays. Other is axial method. In axial method, a slice is taken with one gantry rotation and machine moves a fixed distance and then another slice is taken. So in the end we have parallel slices of cross-sectional imaging. There are two problems with axial imaging. First, body can slightly move between two slices and secondly, a small tumor can lie between two slices thus get missed. So if thickness of slices is 1 cm, a 5-6 mm tumor can lie between two slices and hence completely missed. Helical takes continuous sections while gantry keeps rotating and body keeps moving. So faster imaging is done with decreased chances of any small tumor getting missed. Second, slice thickness. In order to understand concepts of slice, consider a whole unsliced bread. If there is a single foci of mold in this bread, then only way to find it is to do multiple slices of bread and examine both surface of each slice for mold. If mold is small, then there are chances that mold can lie embedded in any one slice with no evidence of it on surface. To avoid this, it is better to cut thinner slices so that mold would get cut in any slice and thus appear on surface. Similar slices are there in CT scan also. Even in helical CT, some scope is there for lesion to get missed between slices. To overcome this, thinnest possible slice thickness must be taken, preferable less than 3 mm. Nowadays, 1 mm or submillimeter thickness is possible in advanced machines. Third, oral contrast. Oral contrast in pancreatic protocol CT scan is neutral. Oral contrast in CT scan can be positive or neutral. Positive contrast is radio opaque, hence shines on imaging. Duodenum gets filled with oral contrasts and shines. This may lead to inaccuracy in diagnosing small periampullary tumors, which lies in immediate vicinity of duodenum. Plus vascular 3D reconstruction is done by using 4 contrast in vessels. So shining oral contrast may overlap with shining vessels and prevent better 3D view. So an oral contrast is chosen which is radiolucent, hence it will dilate duodenum but not make it shine. Tumor will enhance by intravenous contrast and appear distinct in case of dark duodenum. Thus preferred neutral oral contrast used is plain water. Fourth, intravenous contrast. For IV contrast, iodine-containing contrast agents are used at high concentration, more than 300 mg iodine per milliliter, and it is given at higher injection rate of 3 to 5 milliliter per second. This ensures higher contrast amount in tumor within required time, vessels thereby increasing accuracy. Fifth, scan acquisition time. When dye is injected in vein, it goes to heart and gets pumped into aorta and then to arteries. Aorta along with arteries shine. If captured at right time, approximately 10 to 15 seconds after aortic arrival or around 20 to 25 seconds after injection. If done before, dye may not have reached arteries, and if done later, dye would have passed from arteries into parenchyma. This is called early arterial phase and is used to visualize vascular anatomy and aberrant vessels. Dye then enters parenchyma, and organs will enhance depending upon vascularity, so will any vascular lesions. Pancreatic parenchyma will enhance. This is late arterial phase and is taken 40 to 50 seconds after dye injection. Tumors are usually hypervascular and so would concentrate more dye and appear brighter than parenchyma, but pancreatic cancer paradoxically appear hypodense on arterial phase, that is, they appear darker than parenchyma. This is because of peculiar histology of pancreatic adenocarcinoma, dense stroma with high stromal pressure, low cellularity and vessel density. These features leads to low enhancement of pancreatic adenocarcinoma than pancreatic parenchyma. However, pancreatic neuroendocrine tumors are hypervascular and appear bright on arterial phase. This is how pancreatic adenocarcinoma and pancreatic neuroendocrine tumors like insulinoma are differentiated on CT scan. Alimentary tract including pancreas have their venous drainage into portal vein to liver. When image is taken after 65 to 70 seconds, portal venous phase begins in which dye has passed parenchyma and entered portal vein and reached liver. Liver has 75% blood supply from portal vein and 25% from hepatic arteries. So liver enhances more in portal phase and less in arterial phase. So in portal phase liver will appear bright. Liver mets are supplied exclusively by arteries. Due to this they will appear hypodense in portal venous phase and get easily detected. Early arterial phase is for vascular anatomy, late arterial phase is for pancreatic parenchyma, portal venous phase is for liver mets sometimes. There can be delayed phase taken by radiologist 2 to 5 minutes after dye injection. Fibrotic process or tumors with fibrosis visualize better in this phase. So, triple phase usually consists of late arterial phase, portal venous phase and delayed phase. Double phase CT is usually late arterial phase and portal venous phase. Two other phases can be added as and when required, early arterial phase and non-contrast phase before dye injection. 6th, image reconstruction and display. Multiplanar reconstruction is done, that is axial cut, sagittal cut, coronal cut. Three-dimensional reconstruction can also be done.
To our YouTube channel to learn surgery in simple way.